So what is going on, everybody? So what I wanted to show you guys is how to make the Abyssal Whip, and this is what you're going to see. You're going to find this creature in here. This video is mostly going to be on how to solo the Water Serpent. But to solo the Water Serpent, you guys are going to need an Abyssal Whip, which is this thing right here. And to make the Abyssal Whip, you do need Chitin, so you do need to go in the water and find this island creatures. They're called sinking islands. I call them turtles, whatever you want to call them. This is what you need to find. Just remember that these islands do sink on you. And if they do sink, if you have no stamina, you are going to drown. So you want to make sure you have the best, you keep stamina and you're as quick as possible. This is better to do with a team, in my opinion. But the only reason why I'm doing it, I usually would just mark them on the map like I did here and wait for my team to get on. And that's pretty much how I personally would do the island, but at the moment I'm just doing this just to show you guys. And if you get your boat too close, you will crash like you see, and it will send your boat further back out, so you gotta be careful with that. Nah, it's gonna crash again. Maybe not. So just make sure your thing is not so close, so when the water goes down, you're pretty much out of it. So here it is. I feel like it's close enough. I'm going to end up jumping on the island. Just remember, guys, as soon as you start hitting this thing right here. Oh, looks like I left the pickaxe at home, so I'm just going to end up marking the island at the moment. As soon as you end up hitting these things right here, the Abyssal Barque, you're going to get Chitin out of them. What that dude is, you're going to be able to make the Abyssal Whip. And you could do it with bronze pickaxe, iron pickaxe, however you prefer, you think is better for you to do. So right now, it's in my thing, I just find it. And my team's on, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a turtle in here. Just mark it for when my team gets on. So without further ado, now I'm going to go show you guys how to solo the Water Serpentines. And yo. So this is pretty much the moment you guys been waiting for. The Sea Serpent moment. As you're going to see, he's going to stand up. I'm going to try to go towards the wind, because that's the only way you're going to be able to solo this thing. Going towards the wind. It's the only way you're going to get that speed boost that you're going to need. So make sure you're always facing the wind when you're fighting this thing. The next thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to harpoon this thing. So you're going to see me harpoon it. Nope. Apparently that didn't catch. So it's stuck to the thing. So now I have it on. You don't want to do anything else. Just keep following the thing. Just take in mind that, you know, the line can break. And once the line breaks, it's going to be harder for you. So I'm probably going to try to let go of the thing because I'm far away from land. Try to let go of it. Try to put it back on the... Oh, no. My stamina is going back up. I think it's just when it pulls. When it pulls, you, like, slow down so the lines don't break. And it'll pull the thing with you. It'll start pulling it with you. There you go. And then you could just go back to full speed. It's going to hit your boat a couple times. But make sure you lower your pace when it's trying to pull away. Otherwise, it's just going to break off the line because you're going too fast. Once you get it to water, you're not going to fully let go of the speed. You're only going to let it go just a little bit. Like you see me now, my thing is halfway. And once it tries to attack you again, you're going to try to dodge it. It's really hard to do it with this, as you have to keep the pace going with the... Make sure you're not going full speed, otherwise you're going to break the line. Breaking the line is pretty bad, so... You also may take a hit if you don't speed up at the correct amount of time. Just giving you a heads up. Make sure you're not that far from shore. As you can see here, I'm not that far from shore. It's pulling on me, so I'm going to lower the speed and make sure I drag it on. And then once you have it in here, it's super easy to get this thing killed. Once you have it in here, all you got to do... Oh, there's a lot of things here. All you want to do is you're going to start moving. I'm going to take out my shield. You're not going to do anything else. Just move it to the shore. You're going to have to power it through the shore. Literally drag it to the shore. That is the only thing you're going to be able to do. It's going to try to get away from you once you grab it. And actually, those things are helping me out. You see they're beating on it while I'm literally trying to take it away from the water. Once it's out of the water, I have to... This thing is going to start trying to go inside the water again. So that's what you're going to try to kill it. But if you have my hammer... It's pretty easy since you freeze things with the hammer that I have available right now. Jeez. You see the things are taking like freeze damage. That's because my hammer is freezing them. If you don't have the thing, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to drag it a little bit farther into the land. And once you drag it further into the land, you're going to try to hit it a couple of times and then harpoon it again and bring it back into the land. Because like you guys saw, it's just going to start going. Here's the head, the trophy head. There you go, serpentine trophy head. You're going to get trophy meat, whatever, and then you're going to get the scales. So pretty much this is the trophy right here for the serpentine. You get the serpentine meat, and you get 8 serpentine scales per kill. You're going to be able to make this shield that I have right here on me. And what it does is it's going to give you 90 blocked. Yeah, there it is. It gives you 90 block power. 90 block power is pretty amazing. Plus, it looks pretty badass in the back when you're not... You know, when you're holding it in the back. So that's pretty much how you solo the water serpentine. Soloing is pretty easy. And it's not as hard as people think it is. I've only seen people doing it with a group. They try to tell you guys that you have to harpoon it and then have your team with a bow come and bow it. No, you don't have to do any of that. So that's pretty much it, man. I only touched the surface on my map. So I'm going to be doing more guides and videos on how to do this thing.